Welcome for the very first practical. We are going to see the demonstration of the first practical, and the title is, or the aim is, the measurement of various parameters like AC voltage, DC voltage, frequency and phase or phase shift with the help of CRO. In this, we are going to first see the demonstration of the measurement of AC voltage, for which there is a need to have the CRO, the AC voltage source, that is a function generator we will use, and for the measurement of actual AC voltage, we are going to use the digital multimeter. So three different instruments are needed, along with the connecting wires, you may say the crocodile wires, as well as for making the connection of the AC voltage up to the oscilloscope, the CRO probes are used. Now I have turned on the oscilloscope, and as earlier we have seen, a straight line is desirable to be observed. It should be perfectly horizontal. If not, then there is one facility, namely trace rotation on the CRO front panel. With the help of a small screwdriver, you can make the display or a straight line a perfectly horizontal line. Then I will switch on the function generator. Earlier we have gone for the introduction of function generator. The well familiar sine hold or sine waveform we will give from the function generator, whose AC voltage or peak to peak voltage we want to measure. Now from the function generator, I have set a particular frequency, that is 1 kilohertz. Okay, with the help of these two knobs and by setting the frequency range knob at 3 kilohertz, then randomly I have set a particular AC voltage from the level knob. As soon as I will switch the CRO channel into the AC mode, that particular sine wave with a frequency of 1 kilohertz having specific amplitude will get displayed on the CRO screen. Now, in the mid, we are going to connect the digital multimeter. Already in the introductory video, we have seen the digital multimeter details, how to make the connection and how to carry out the measurement. In that one, we have also learned that the digital multimeter always reads or indicates the RMS value of the AC voltage. Whereas on CRO, there will be a display of complete waveform from which either you can measure the peak to peak, that is from negative peak to positive peak, or only the peak one. From the center line, either you can go for the positive peak or you can come to the negative peak. So only two measurements are possible with the help of CRO. But the DMM is indicating the RMS value. That's why there is a need to convert the RMS value, which is measured by the DMM, into the peak to peak value, so that we can do the comparison between the value measured with the help of DMM and the value measured with the help of CRO. First of all, I will switch on the DMM. I have switched it to the AC voltage mode, and simultaneously I have connected the CRO also and the DMM also to the function generator. Now I will start the measurement, and the very first column in the observation table will be the actual RMS voltage. From the display of DMM, it is reading 1.398. Okay. So I will convert 1.398 RMS into the peak to peak voltage, so that later on we can be able to compare in terms of the percentage error in the measurement. Now the next column will be vertical divisions occupied by the AC voltage. Now from the CRO screen, I have aligned the negative peak at a particular horizontal marking, and if I will read how many vertical divisions are present by exactly aligning it by the position knobs, that is the vertical position and horizontal position knobs, and now there are 3 complete divisions from the negative peak, 1, 2 and 3, and the fourth is up to 0.8. So in total my AC voltage have occupied on the CRO screen total 3.8 divisions. As per the next column, vertical divisions, and these are equal to 3.8. Now either you may keep the RMS reading as it is, you may convert the peak to peak into RMS, or you may keep peak to peak as it is and you may convert the RMS, which is read by the DMM, into the peak to peak. So for this one, we will convert the peak to peak value read by the CRO into the RMS one. Now the display on the CRO reads for channel 1 the volts per division setting equal to 1 volt. So as per the observation table, in the third column we have to note down the volts per division setting for channel 1. So it will be 1 volt per division. Now if I want to calculate the peak to peak voltage, then I have to multiply number of divisions, which are 3.8, into the volts per division setting, which is 1 volt per division. So it will be equal to 3.8 volts. So from the oscilloscope I have read the value of peak to peak voltage equal to 3.8 volts. If you will convert it into the RMS one, so we have to use the equation that V RMS is equal to V peak to peak divided by 2 root 2. If you will substitute the values, then after calculation we will get the measured RMS value of the applied AC voltage equal to 1.344, and the actual RMS value will be read by the DMM, which is equal to 1.397 or 398. Now the units are same, that is RMS, so we can compare in terms of the calculation of percentage error. We know the equation for percentage error, which is equal to the measured value minus the actual value upon the actual value into 100. So if I will substitute all the values, so percentage error will be equal to 1.344 minus 1.397 upon 1.397 into 100. So after calculation we will get the percentage error in the measurement of the AC voltage.